Hey guys, welcome to PrimeTime Kitchen's How Tuesday, episode 5. And tonight we're going to have a lot of fun. I'm going to show you guys a couple techniques that you maybe don't know about. And we're going to make something that you can use the base of the idea to make a bunch of different things. So it's kind of a cool, just the idea of making a cake of something. So tonight on the menu we have, we're going to do some chicken piccata, which is chicken with lemon, capers, fresh parsley, red onion, and a little bit of tomato at the end. We're going to do that on top of a zucchini roasted red pepper cake. We're going to make like a little cake. And then, I don't know if you guys heard of the show with Theo from Willow Tree. White asparagus is in season, and thank God Whole Foods had like 4 bundles of it left, and I swear to God that's it. I grabbed one. So we're going to do some char-braised, I don't even know if that's a word actually, asparagus with that. And of course our piccata sauce is going to be perfect. And believe it or not, even though you see a lot of stuff here, this actually is a pretty easy dish, and I think this is one of those dishes that you guys can make, like when friends come over, that's not steak or something like that, that you can impress somebody with. It is a real flavorful dish, a lot of fun to make, and it looks incredible on the plate. First things first, before we get started, let's order a couple things. You'll see the t-shirt I'm wearing. It's what we call our Fresh Cuts shirt. See it on the back? These are actually available right now at ptkradio.com. We just had our shipment in. We also have some stickers and some other stuff coming. So if you guys are so interested in maybe wearing some stuff that supports the show while you're out and around, we certainly would appreciate that. Didn't hurt at all. Also, we want you to always stay in touch with us on Twitter and on Instagram. On Instagram, it's Primetime Kitchen. On Twitter, it's PTK Real Radio. We need all the likes we can get, and it's going to be a good time. We always start every show with the beer of the day, which, by the way, if you'd like to bring the beer, you're fine. So this is a company that came in beer of the week a while back, man. This is MIA Brewing, and this
cool
is...
Cool colors.
Well, think about it. Miami's like...
It looks like Miami Vice, well, totally.
All these cans... It's called Miami Vice. Vice beer.
Well, oh, okay, cool.
All of these cans are like this, these real retro, like art deco colors. And they actually carry this to Whole Foods. We get this to Whole Foods, and they carry a number of their beers. They make a beer, by the way, called Domino that is, I believe it's like a Pills. It's like a real crispy, but it's very, very good. But this beer is a Vice beer. The reason I chose this one tonight is because, for one thing, it's a local Florida beer. Secondly, this is going to be perfect with this dish. If you're not a white wine drinker, this is going to be really, really good with this dish. So we're going to get started, and cheers, by the way, baby. You can see my wife is drinking Decoy Pinot Noir, which is very good. You can get it at Sam's, like $20 a bottle. That's a great deal, by the way.
It's very tasty.
We have our oven preheated to 300 degrees.
Yep.
We have our cast iron skillet.
Of course. Is it on fire department level? Or, like, are we going to have to run in?
Just set it to Safe Touch.
Well, Safe Touch tried to call me, but I was going through Facebook Live, which is why the fire department came.
And they tried to call me, too, I figured out. So the fire department just said, well, they're not calling. They may be dead. We just go ahead and go over. So we have this on, like, medium. And I'll tell you why in a second, because when we sear these chicken breasts, we're going to do a little coating on, a little flour. Piccata usually has that little bitty flour coating, which lets it hold onto the sauce. We're going to keep true with that. That way we can show you how to kind of do a little bread something. And we have our char pan here, which is basically your cast iron. It's just basically a griddle pan, right? We're going to mark our asparagus for that. So let's get started on
getting... Is that ceramic?
No, it's cast iron enameled.
Okay, gotcha.
So we have some fresh parsley.
Yep.
Panko breadcrumbs.
Yep.
Yellow onion.
Yes.
Little block of Parmesan cheese.
Delicious.
Some Mount Olive roasted red pepper.
Yep.
We have some Cinto. Not only do they move you, they'll also give you a damn good artichoke heart.
Right.
Artichoke hearts. We have a little paprika.
Yep.
We have some capers, lemon, red onion. We have some fresh tomato, 2 eggs, right? Some garlic, butter, white wine, chicken stock breast. Now, that seems like a lot. We're all going to put this online. Now, look, I promise this time, I learned how to run my wife's computer, so tonight, as soon as we get done with this, hot tub for the party. And then after that, I'm going to sit down and type this out so you guys can have it. And if you go to ptkradio.com, we're doing a really good job at getting those up. And if you'll check out the way we do it, you have those little check boxes where you can check what you have. It's a really cool way. You can print that page out if you're going to the store to create this.
Well, you can double the recipe is what it is. So you can double or triple the recipe if you're cooking for a bunch of people. Most of those recipes are good for about Four. Okay.
Three to five, but really it's like four people. Tonight we're only making three.
Okay. Meals. Yeah. So if you need to double that or triple it, there's an option on there as well.
That's a really good point. And another thing too is it also acts like a cool shopping list because you can click off what you have and then what you don't have, take it to the store. Boom, you're ready to go.
They said print. It's 2000. That's 2008.
You're right. It is so 2008. Got me. Okay. So we're gonna do our zucchini first, and here's why.
Okay.
Okay. This is the important part of cooking zucchini. Let's get all our stuff out of the way here. Zucchini has a lot of what, Tori?
Water.
It's got a lot of water.
A lot of wet.
We've learned earlier in these episodes that we don't like wet when we're trying to get a good crispy sear.
Right.
So what we're going to do is we're going to drain this water, or we're going to drain the zucchini.
Okay.
First, going to just cut our nub off here.
All right. Get the nubs off.
Get the nubs off. And really, this is too many. The recipe that you can do this really calls for like one or two. I just use my potato peeler.
Yep.
Pretty simple. Now, a lot of dishes, I actually leave the skin on. When we make zoodles, which we'll do in another PTK soon, we'll do some zoodles for you guys. Because
zoodles are the best.
Pesto with that mahi. There's a picture of it up right now. You can see it was delicious. We would probably add a little roasted red pepper sauce to that now just because we'd want a little bit more acid in it. But it was a great dish.
It was really good.
It was exceptionally good. But we leave the skin on for those because I think it gives a little bit of crunch and body.
Right.
Of course, with all this water here, we're not going to get a lot of crunch. You just kind of get that thing. So let's set this one to the side. I don't think I need that one, Tori. We're just going to make it for you and I because the eating machine is not here tonight.
No, she's at her boyfriend's house in Tampa.
At the Rays game right now.
She is at the Rays. Who's at the Rays game with her?
Jim Furyk.
Jim Furyk.
And she spelled it like F-E-R-R-I-C-K. God love her. So we're going to go ahead and peel these on down. And the potato peeler does a great job. You know, it's a pretty easy thing to do. So we want to cut this nub as well. So we'll get the potato peel off to the side. And here is the trick.
Show us the trick.
Well, this is one of them. Okay. Now, they tell you to grate this right down the middle. But if you look, even in the middle, this one actually isn't that bad. Maybe some of those other, that's what you get when you buy really good quality vegetables, by the way. Yeah, we're going to go ahead and do this one just like this.
Okay.
That's the difference between buying the,
organic
stuff and...
Well, it's organic, right?
It is organic, yeah. So we have our big grater, the one that you would use for cheddar cheese or whatever.
Yeah.
And we're just going to big grate this right into this thing. It really isn't that big of a deal. Probably going to wipe a knuckle or two out here in a second.
Don't do that because gross.
Yeah, gross is for sure. So we're going to... And you can feel these things just squeezing crazy water out as we're doing it. But you'll look, I'll show you in one second, that we have a really beautiful little chop here with this grater.
Yep.
And we'll do one more.
Okay.
So basically, can you see that, baby?
Yeah, I got you.
Basically, get that all in there. Get that base up because we want nothing but that. And we'll keep going here. It's really enough to show you what we're going to do. And the trick really is a little different than you think. The trick is like this. Okay, so here's the difference when you do zucchini.
Okay.
So spread this out. Can you get over here on top and see?
Yeah.
Spread this out. Now, you can already see there's a lot of water. But there's water you can't see. Okay?
Okay.
So what we're going to do is this. We're going to actually a little bit of salt.
Okay.
We're going to salt this. Now, anybody who knows anything, salt really does bring water out. So, we're going to let that sit off to the side for a few minutes.
Okay.
Now, actually, I'm going to go ahead and put it in my colander. So, what I do is I'm going to go ahead and put it in my colander. As you see a sieve here.
Okay.
Right? And I'm going to let it sit. And the reason I'm going to let it sit is I'm going to let that salt work and take some of that water out of this zucchini.
Is it salt or sea salt?
Sea salt. I use kosher salt. You can use sea salt. Just don't use iodized salt. And the reason why, it's just so hard to gauge how salty it's going to get. And it has that sharp, salty flavor. It doesn't have the really good kind of mellow.
Right.
It has that.
Yeah.
That, you don't
bitter.
Want,
yeah, bitter.
You don't want that. You know what this? You want this.
Stop. Don't do that. Don't do that face.
And that's what you want.
A little weird.
Okay. So, our zucchini is resting.
Okay.
So, basically, when we get done with this, we're gonna reintroduce this bowl here.
Okay.
Which you'll see how much this. And I'm going to set this heavy bowl right on top of that. And it's going to squeeze water out of that. Then we're going to mix that up. Because once we get those mixed up, they're going to just pan fry and we're going to be ready to go. So let's go ahead and get our mix ready for our chicken, okay?
Okay.
Now, When you do chicken and you're doing a little coating,
gotta get a drink real quick.
You can get a drink. Let me grab some milk while you do that.
Oh, okay, that's fine.
So we got a little milk here.
Oh, okay.
Turn that down a little bit because my cast iron gets so hot.
So hot.
So hot. Yeah. And so we're gonna make what they call an egg wash.
Okay.
I don't know if you guys know what an egg wash is. We're gonna do one egg into our pan here. Okay. Very simple. We're gonna do a little milk. What, a quarter of a cup?
How much is that?
Quarter of a cup.
Okay. Are you sure?
You'll see all the, and obviously you know how I feel about measuring a lot. Because we do it so much. Well, so just stir this egg up with that milk and get that incorporated.
Okay.
Okay. Now, on just a plain old paper plate, we like to use China because we're bougie.
We are bougie.
We're bougie.
Oh, you like my word from last week.
Half a cup of just regular old all-purpose flour.
Okay.
We're going to season this. Pinch of salt, which is going to be probably about a half a teaspoon. We're going to give it a couple good cracks of black pepper.
Okay.
All right. A couple good cracks of black pepper. And we're going to stir this flour up. You don't really need to season this a lot because we're going to have a lot of flavor in this dish. A lot of flavor. So we're not going to have to kill ourselves to
get it. Yeah, it's one of my favorite for sure.
Yeah. I mean, actually been making it for the kids for a while too. The kids even like it. And believe it or not, it has artichoke.
What was that?
Artichoke hearts. It has artichoke hearts and people are like, ow, God.
Trevor wants to know who taught you that word.
What?
Bougie.
Oh, man.
Your wife. You can say it. It's fine.
No,
just go ahead. No, it's fine.
Little Uzi Vert. Little Uzi Vert. I think that's what it is.
I don't know.
All right. So, now, I didn't say this was a low
fat. For the latecomers, what are you making?
We're making chicken piccata over zucchini and red roasted pepper cakes with char braised white asparagus.
Yes.
And we're drinking MIA.
And decoy. This, gentlemen, if you want to get your wife some delicious wine.
Yeah, that's a good bottle.
That she will thank you for.
And you can get this at like Sam's Club and save like probably $6 a bottle. Because if you buy this in the store, if you were to get a bottle of that at a restaurant, it would be like $60.
Right. So but it's $20, right?
$20 at Sam's.
Yeah.
So I did not say this dish was like low fat. There's some butter in this dish. Here's why. Because nothing in the world is going to give us that great golden color on these chicken breasts like butter. So into our...
There's the butter. It's too hot. It's too hot, babe.
No, it's not, actually.
Just kidding. I don't know.
Okay, so in there a little bit of butter. And believe it or not, I've had this going for a while. I do want to get that off that pan for a second. Because that, again... It carries so much heat. So, what I do is I move everything over to my cooking area.
Yep.
Okay?
Yep.
And I work toward the pan.
Yep. Less mess, right?
Yeah, less mess. You want to work toward the pan just simply because you don't have to worry about taking that stuff all over that area. All
right, I'm going to come around you. There we go.
Now, even though we did the seasoning in the flour, we are going to lightly season these chicken breasts with some salt and pepper.
Okay.
Just because you want that flavor under the flour as well.
Ralph said you need to cook on a gas stove.
Thanks, Ralph. I appreciate that.
every week.
Anytime Ralph wants to go out and grab one for me.
No, it's not the problem is not the gas stove. The problem is the gas, right?
That's going to be a problem. So, salt, pepper.
Yep. Hey, Mike.
All right.
Rocky said Tori was right. I don't know what he's talking about, but I'm pretty sure I was.
All right, here we go. Ready?
Yep.
Flour first.
Okay.
Egg wash.
Yep.
Flour again.
Okay. Why do you do that?
Because that way the flour helps the egg wash stick to the chicken, and we get a really good, crispy chicken outer. And you gotta remember, with this butter, we're already at that beautiful brown color we want.
Okay.
So that into the mawash. Alright. If you notice also, I'm working with one hand and trying to keep the other hand as clean as possible.
Yeah.
Okay. Now we're only gonna do two in this one here, so I'll do another one in a second.
Hi, Roy.
So what we're gonna do is we're cooking these early because we're waiting for our zucchini to get that water out of the zucchini.
Okay.
When you play the video back and you'll see as kind of we move forward getting it done, that you want that resting time. It doesn't matter because this dish comes together I mean, when everything's done, because what I'm going to do is I'm going to cook this chicken, and we're going to stick it in the oven. I'm going to get it brown on the outside, and we're going to throw it in the oven and let it rest there at 300, because I don't care if it takes a little longer to get done.
Yeah.
That gives me time to get my zucchini patties together,
okay,
to get those fried, to get my asparagus ready. I'm not really worried about the chicken cooking. It's going to cook. So all I want to do is make sure I got the color that I want.
Yeah.
Which is that beautiful golden brown color, which we're going to get here in a second.
Brandon said that he's eaten ramen noodles, and he's shaking his head at rich people.
Okay.
We're not rich, obviously, because we're on an electric stove.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, electric stove. That's does not connotate loaded.
Is that farm fresh chicken?
That's chicken from Whole Foods. We like shopping at Whole Foods because we get good vegetables there. And
yep,
believe it or not, honestly, and just let me say this quickly, because we choose to shop there. You can shop at Publix and Winn-Dixie. We choose to shop there because we do find that the flavor in the veggies is great.
So much better.
Also, they do have a very good meat department. Again, not taking anything away from anybody. They get some of the better. See, I've seen great scallops and shrimp there lately. So
right.
So we've had real good luck with Whole Foods. So we like going there.
Willie wants to know what beer you're drinking.
I'm drinking MIA. It's called Miami Vice. V-R-W-I-E-S-S, which is, Belgian ale.
Vice.
So it's a vice beer. So
yeah.
And it's good. The reason I'm drinking it tonight is as I was standing in front of the cooler. This is a local beer, by the way. My breweries are local. It's a Florida brewery.
Yeah.
And as I was standing in front of the cooler, I was like, that's going to be great. A vice beer is perfect for this.
Yeah.
Because it does have a little bit of flavor in there itself. And it almost drinks a little bit like I can't say that because it doesn't. But it just has flavor that's going to complement this dish a lot.
Okay.
Let's see how our zucchini. Let's go ahead and get our weight.
Okay.
Our zucchini. So,
you're adding water to it?
Yeah, give some weight.
Okay. That's good.
Now, and I'll show you, it's kind of cool. You'll see when we get done, when we squeeze this out, we're still going to squeeze the hell out of it. Even after it rests a little bit, we're going to squeeze it good. So you'll see how much water that releases.
Okay.
So, chicken breast?
Yeah.
There you go. Look at that brown. See,
that's
we want. That's what we want right there. So, believe it or not, that's not going to take very long for that other breast to get done. We'll get this other one done.
Okay.
My tiny little pan. My tiny, tiny, tiny little pan. It's like,
it is not. Shut up. Those are big breasts.
Whoa, dude. Well, thank you. I appreciate that. I just got them fixed, and they feel good.
Don't do that.
And really, the rest of this dish, man, I'm going to tell you, this zucchini cake, I think you guys are going to love, because whether it be zucchini, whether it be sweet potato, whether it be squash, seriously, break up cauliflower in little bits and make cakes with those, because once you see how this binds together, you're gonna be like, oh my God, I could put bacon in there, you could put herbs in there, you literally can do whatever you want with it.
Yeah.
And you guys who want to start showcasing and, plating your dishes to have it look great, as you see tonight when we plate this dish, it gives you a great base to build your dish up.
Right.
I still see a lot of people online, like, plating their dishes the old cafeteria way. You got a dish here, you got your side there, you got that side
right,
there.
Right.
Start mixing that up a little bit. Come up with creative ideas. Go online and look at, just Google plating food and get the idea of how people are kind of making food look great. Eat with your eyes
you
first.
Eat with your eyes first. That's
always
what you've always said.
Eat with your eyes first. So,
yep.
I'm going to get this in. For this beautiful.
So, for the people that are just joining, what's the shredded stuff that we just put weight on?
It's zucchini.
Yeah.
Shredded zucchini. We shredded it like it was hash browns.
And what are we? Why do we have the weight on it?
Because it has a lot of water. So what we're doing is we added a little bit of salt to it.
Okay.
So you shred it up. Add some salt to it. Get a little water there.
Yeah.
You add some salt to it, and salt actually helps. Look at the water there where it's built up already.
Wow. Yep.
Salt actually will help pull the water out of there. Then we're squishing it down, and we're even going to do. We're going to take a spatula in a minute. We're really going to press it through there. And I actually made it like that. We want all that water out of there as much as possible.
Right.
All right. Let's get these out of here. These are really good. We have the color we want. That's really all that matters.
Yep.
Okay, let's go and get our other chicken breast in.
Okay.
That's got to cool down a little bit. That is going.
So you go flour, egg.
Flour. Egg wash, which is one egg and about a quarter cup of milk.
Yeah.
It really doesn't even matter what kind of milk. It could be whole
milk. And flour again, right?
And then flour again. It's going to get you that little breading that you like. That's kind of like your basic breading.
Yeah.
Into the pan.
Yeah.
I'm going to throw this out.
Okay.
And
Mikey said that he heard zucchini was blowing up right now.
Well, zucchini is blowing up right now. It's blowing up because I said it was going to blow up.
Along with carrots and Brussels sprouts?
Carrots, Brussels sprouts.
Okay.
Look, the veggie world, guys, is explosive in itself. So the veggie world is exploding. I called it. I get all the credit. You don't have to worry about being free. Look, their butter's in there. You're going to get fat. Don't matter. Just keep buttering it up. It's going to be good. You can do this with olive oil. Let me say that real quick. I didn't say it. I think you get the best flavor in browning with butter, but you could do this. You could do a tablespoon of butter, a tablespoon of olive oil.
Tiny more healthier.
It is a little bit healthier, actually. And the butter also gives flavor, but the olive oil will work. You can make this easily with olive oil. Let's face it, this isn't far from chicken parm.
Yeah.
Chicken parm, guys, for the record, instead of using the flour, you use Italian breadcrumbs. And you fry your chicken breast like that, and then cover it in tomato sauce and mozzarella cheese, and you got chicken parm.
Orlando didn't know that you can use cast iron on a gas top. Oh, and Lori said that you could squeeze the water out with a kitchen towel.
You can. Matter of fact, what you also can do is, what they show you also is, you can get cheesecloth. You know cheesecloth?
Yeah.
Pile in there and basically just twist it until it comes out. What you don't want to do is toss it around a lot. You don't want to break those little shards or those little, little pieces of zucchini. You don't want to break that up.
Yep.
Because it'll just turn into mush. You want it to have some body and have that look, because you want it to kind of look like a cake. You'll see.
Okay.
You'll see. Almost there. So like I said, our oven's at 300 degrees. These are not cooked all the way through. You can still see they're very gelatinous.
Right.
All right. But that doesn't matter, because we're going to cook them at 300 and keep them nice and warm.
In the oven, right?
Yeah, so that when we go to plate, we have a good hot piece of chicken that's cooked perfectly all the way through. And it's still nice and juicy. Look at our browning right there. Look how good that is.
Meredith, this is the second time somebody's asked, do you ever cook with ghee? I think it's ghee versus butter.
Ghee is kind of like a butter, isn't it? Yeah, I saw that at the store the other day, because it's like G-H-E-E, right?
Yes.
So I've seen that. The answer is I haven't cooked with it. And I just saw it for the first time, I think. Actually, Whole Foods hasn't. So I just saw it for the first time, and I'll grab some if you want me to cook with it. Hell, I don't know. I bought this.
Let's try it.
I got this. I got some avocado oil.
Ooh, I love that.
Well, I don't know if I do or not.
I do, because we had the spray stuff, like the pan.
I know that you can get it up to 500 degrees, and that's all that matters. So I did cook a little something with it. It does have kind of a unique flavor to it, kind of a nutty. It's kind of cool, but really not overpowering at all. I mean, I hope it works, because I love the vegetable oil thing. It's a little sketchy.
Jeez, what temp are you on the stovetop?
Oh, that's just like medium.
We are...
Yeah, just medium.
We're at 6.
Look, really, that's what you need to pay attention to. Look. That's really the most important thing. That tiny little bubble on the edge is how it fries like that.
Right.
That's really what you want.
Slow.
That doesn't even matter. It's whatever causes that to happen.
Right.
Is what you want. So we're almost done with these.
Okay.
And then once we get that going, we're going to squeeze out our zucchini, and it is going to start cracking.
Brandon's grandma cooks with butter, and then adds some more butter.
Oh, yeah. Well.
That's flavor.
You know what? I need to meet that grandmother then, Brandon. How's she looking?
That was a little creepy. Stop that.
We got an open marriage here. We can do whatever we want.
Ghee is butter melted with milk solids removed.
So it's like, it's not clarified butter, right? That sounds like what clarified butter is. But clarified butter is...
Yeah, that's what Tony said. Yeah, it's clarified butter.
Oh, yeah, because you can get that hot. He's right. You can get that hot. It doesn't react like butter. But does
it have the same, like...
Well, what causes butter to burn is those solids. Remember when we made that brown butter sauce for the scallops? That's what made it brown, is those solids burning.
Yep.
All right, let's get this off here. This is ready to go.
What about grapeseed oil? Have you ever cooked with that?
I haven't. I've heard it's cool. Haven't tried it because...
Let me see.
All right. Chicken breast.
Yeah.
You're going to put them right on the top.
I got
300
you.
Degrees.
Yep.
Boom. Let's move this over here.
Yep.
We're still going to use that.
I'm coming over here though, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
So, here we go. So I want to come right here soon.
Okay.
Even where that thing was sitting, look at that puddle of water there.
Yeah.
Look at
that. Oh, wow. Oh, that's cool.
Now look.
Oh, wow. And the salt helped that, right?
The salt really... I mean, think about that. I'm squeezing that out right now. Like, the salt really helped that a lot.
Interesting.
And see, believe it or not, that little ball will stay just like that for a minute while I get this up, because we want to use as much of this as possible.
Mark, our stovetop is super scratched up, so no, we're not afraid of that.
No.
Apparently.
I think the third day we had it, I just put a massive scratch, and Tori just looked at me, cursed a bunch, and then just went to sleep.
Yeah, whatever. What are you going to do?
So pretty.
Works great, higher temperature, flavor. the same texture, a little different.
For what?
I guess the ghee. What were we talking about?
Well, it's butter. I mean, so it's gonna have a great texture. It'll be good.
All right. Jesus? He wants to know how long you cook the chicken in the oven.
Oh, honestly, 20 minutes. Long enough for me to cook this. So 25 minutes or so. All right. So we have our zucchini is in the bowl.
Yeah.
So what I'll do is I'll just set that so you can see. Yeah. We'll add some stuff as we go.
That's cool.
All right. So we have a yellow onion.
Yep. How do you cut that?
You guys have to watch me cut onions. For the life of me, I don't understand why. But you do. So we'll do one.
Okay. Brandon just said she's 69. Oh. His grandmother. Oh. He said that's a perfect age. Sadie wants to know if we have an open marriage. That would be a negative, Sadie.
We do not. Mm-hmm. So we're going to just dice this onion up. We're only going to use half this. Okay.
Danielle wants to know where you came up with the idea of doing this dinner tonight.
Honestly, I'll tell you straight up. I saw a recipe. We were kind of challenged with what we're going to do tonight. And I saw a recipe that Heather, my partner at PrimeTime Kitchen, put up for a corn cake. And I was like, well, I don't want to do a corn cake because it's not going to fit with what we're doing, but I could do a zucchini cake. That'd be kind of cool. Because I think it fits perfectly. We can get exactly what we want in here.
Where do you get your knives?
This is a Shoon knife.
Yeah.
I got it at Wassey's Meats and Malden. The head sponsor or PrimeTime Kitchen and the great people. And these are unbelievably good knives. The balance, as you can see, is crazy good. The blade is very versatile and we love it. Parmesan cheese. Now look, this is not measured, but you want to do about a quarter cup.
Okay.
It looks about like that.
Okay.
Don't want to get any onion paper in there, though, do we?
We do not.
Panko breadcrumbs. Now, if you remember earlier in the show, I told you there was going to be a basis that you can make almost anything with. If you have panko breadcrumbs and one of these chicken bombs, you can literally make any...
Wait, did you just call that egg a chicken bomb?
A chicken bomb? You can make damn near anything into a cake. Do you see... Seriously, this sticks this together, and then anything near it is going to stick to it. You form it into a patty, and you fry it.
There you go.
It's pretty easy. So, we're going to do... This is about half a cup.
Okay.
So, we're going to do about a cup.
Okay.
Panko breadcrumbs.
Yep.
Salt.
Gotcha.
Pepper.
Trevor calls his ex a chicken bomb.
Well, tell Trevor thanks for sharing. We appreciate it. A little bit of paprika. Paprika, very nice.
Jimmy, your snarky comments is the reason why they listen.
Oh, tell them. Thank you. We appreciate it. We like snark. We speak snark.
Randy loves Wassies.
Oh, awesome. Tell Randy I love Wassies as well. They're great people. And
they can hear you.
Their sponsorship has been... Really, to be honest with you, it's been a blessing to get the show off the road. I mean, out of the, just kind of out and around so we can do it. I mean, without them coming on board and really seeing the value of the show early, the show probably wouldn't even be where it is right now. One clove of garlic, couple cloves of garlic, two small ones.
Yep.
Piece of cake. Don't want to overwhelm it with garlic. A lot of people are like, oh, garlic's the greatest. I'll do that. Don't do that.
Garlic is the greatest.
It is great.
It is.
Egg.
All right.
In... Now.
Okay.
Fork. Toss this together.
Okay.
Don't get too aggressive. All you want to do is break that egg up.
Just get it, yeah.
Yeah, just make sure all the zucchini and all of the...
What was that?
Just a piece of onion that wasn't cut right.
Oh, okay.
We want it good, man. Now, here's where the cool part is. So we have ours mixed together. And really, to be honest with you, we're going to form that in cakes and we're about to fry them here in 1 second. If you see, like if you can pick that up and you see it's not sticking together right or whatever, add a few more breadcrumbs if you need to, right? If you need a little bit more egg, add a little bit more egg to it.
Okay.
Okay, so you want these things to bind up really nice. So even when you form your balls, your zucchini patties or whatever, what you don't want to do is you don't want to compress it too much, okay? You want to make the patty, you want to make it light, all right? Don't mash it down because what's going to happen is the zucchini all cook together and it'll turn into mush.
Yeah.
So let's get our hand back on.
Lori wants to know if I cook like you.
Lori, she cooks exactly like me.
Except baking. I can bake.
You can bake. Nobody said you couldn't bake.
Don't high-pitch talk to me.
We're going to use a little olive oil.
Okay.
We have butter left over.
Yep.
So we're going to use a little bit of olive oil in there. And here's the cool thing about these cakes as well.
Yeah.
Because our chicken is still cooking.
Okay.
We can make these whenever. Because once I get them pan fried and get them heated all the way through, in the oven they go, they can rest. So then after that, we're making our piccata sauce. And then we're going to be ready to go.
Okay.
Let's let this butter be up to heat. Let me take another drink of beer. I may just slam it.
What are you drinking? They actually did ask me what you're drinking.
This is called MIA. It's a Miami Vice. It's a Vice beer for MIA breweries. They're a Florida brewery. And we like them.
Yeah.
They also have another beer tried out called Domino that is exceptionally good.
They just joined. What are you making? Sorry.
Tell them thank you so much. We're doing a chicken piccata over a zucchini and roasted red pepper.
Red pepper.
See? This is how easy it is when you get me sidetracked where I don't get to put in my stuff.
Well,
it's your fault, dude.
You need to pay attention.
No, it's your fault. So, and roasted red pepper, zucchini cake with Parmesan cheese, and other cool stuff.
Yeah.
So, again, look at that color then. Boom. Boom. And I could put a little parsley in here. Nah, I'm not going. All right.
Yeah.
So, we have our hot pan. Okay. Because this is the presentation base.
Okay.
We really want this to be a pretty good size.
How much are you putting in there? Like,
what do you mean, how much am I putting in there?
Well, I'm like the size, the amount.
I don't know. It's probably about a
like a patty, like a hamburger patty.
That needs more paint.
Okay.
That needs more paint.
Okay.
It's a little too wet. So let's break that one up and get some more.
Mikey said that you need a dry erase board of what dish you're cooking and what beer you're drinking in the background.
Well. Thank you so much for his...
They said that that's a good idea.
Okay. So we're going to make three pretty good size these patties.
Yep.
Alright.
Yep.
And even then, look at it, still got some water coming out.
Looks like crab cakes.
It does look a little bit. And again, like we said, I just said that because if you think about what we're making, it's a cake, and really crab cakes have the panko or the breadcrumbs. Crab cakes have... the egg, yolk, you know, crab cakes have all that. So.
Do you like any dogfish head beers?
Yes. Let me tell you what. It's funny you should mention that. So I was at Luke's in Maitland, which is good. You should go there. Check it out at least once, right?
Yeah.
We're at Luke's. And.
Oh, the Namaste?
Dogfish head has a beer called Namaste that I'm absolutely in love with. It is the delicious. Okay. So. Now, those are going to pan sear exactly like we were talking about there. So we're going to sear these up and get them good color on them.
Miss Rita said they look epic already.
Thank you, Miss Rita. Well, she's the sweetest.
She is the sweetest.
Miss Rita is the sweetest.
I can't like her post, though, for some reason.
Miss Rita is the real. The real. All right, let's check our chicken breast real quick.
Okay.
See? Just kind of chilling. You can actually feel them. They're still a little cushy. All right.
They're chilling, and you can fill them.
So here's what we can do, actually. We're going to turn this up a little bit. It's going to turn up 325.
James wants to know if you've had a beer called Aardwolf. A-A-R-D-F-O-L-F?
I have not. I haven't heard of that.
I don't know. Tina loves PTK.
Oh, tell her thank you so much. I appreciate it. So...
our dinner guest is our daughter, our other daughter. Say hey, y'all.
That's the artist.
The artiste.
The artisto. The artisto. So, here's the cool thing. And think about when we're making this for dinner. You know, we prepped up pretty good, but we're going a little bit slower to show you guys kind of how we're doing things. This is this actually is going pretty quick. We're just kind of taking our time. But all this kind of goes together good. This is a great drinking wine, hanging out kind of meal because there's different stages. I could have prepped this beforehand so that when I came home, like all the zucchini could have done the night before and it goes bam, 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 you're done. The sauce comes together pretty quickly, which we're going to make right here in this pan. Because what we're going to do is we're going to use everything in this pan. I'm going to deglaze this after sautéing some red onion and some garlic. Matter of fact, while this is cooking, come on over, we'll do that.
Dora doesn't have a cast iron. Can you cook that on like a regular pan?
Of course you can.
Are they holding together?
Yeah. It's weird when I cook them in this. cast iron thing. It hasn't did it. I mean, this is a real cooking show. We're going to keep it real, players. We're going to keep it real. All right. Red onion. Yum, yum. Right? Yum, yum. Okay, so with the chicken piccata,
yep. We
just basically want to use the red onion in there to add that a little bit of that onion flavor. So basically what I'm saying is we're not going to be using a ton of red onion. We're really not. We're just going to cut it in that. You'll see we'll cut it in halves.
Yeah.
And then we'll the pieces that we build our sauce, you'll see how it fits in there. We're using this as a veggie. So cut them nice and thin.
How do you clean your cast iron?
Salt and warm water.
Somebody wants you to do a live show with an audience member.
Oh, have somebody come in?
Yeah, do a contest. Yeah. I guess that would be kind of cool.
Yeah, I can imagine a stranger in my house. I can certainly see it. Yes, come on in, person I've never met before. Who probably has completely non-nefarious.
Oh, they've never seen the eagle cook.
Look at this.
Oh, look at you. See, you just needed to cook a little longer.
Look at those colors.
Look at that. Okay. That looks amazing.
Now, when you turn it over, give me a little squasher, okay? Give me a little squash, because we want that thing to be down a little bit, because we want it to heat all the way through.
Yeah.
So that's nice and squashy. So we're going to let that cook.
Okay.
We're going to let that get brown, too. Then we're going to transfer those cakes into the oven with the chicken. And for the only thing, just to keep it warm, so when we build our sauce and we pull those out, they're ready to plate, ready to go. And we're going to go ahead and start preheating our char pan. So while we're doing that, I need to... and also, when you're making the sauce for this dish, don't mince your garlic. We're actually going to do it like Goodfellas?
Okay.
When that scene when they're in the movie, and you slice the garlic real thin. That's the secret, right? We do kind of want that. I want thin slices of garlic in the sauce. I don't want it kind of chopped up. So I'm going to come in.
So we have a bunch of people that made the Brussels sprouts.
Yeah.
So
they're amazing, aren't they?
They are so good.
Was I joking that you could just make them and snack on them like they're popcorn?
Yeah.
It's like literally my favorite thing in the world to eat right now is those Brussels sprouts. I think you have to have bacon or prosciutto or something in them, though. I really do. I don't think it's the same without that.
Mike said to slice it with a straight razor.
That guy's a wise ass. All right, a little artichoke heart. I'm going to get this right. I'm going to drain these.
Yeah. Draining the artichoke heart.
Okay.
Okay.
Those are ready to go. Got some capers ready to go. Mm. You're going to love the sauce when it comes together. Okay, let's go and prep this asparagus.
Okay.
Leave the rubber band on.
Half clove of garlic.
Yeah. Leave the rubber band on. There's really no reason to do that. That way you don't have to worry about it. It's all set to go.
Well, you're doing it too fast and I didn't get that.
You're too fast. You got to wash your pan out real quick.
Yep. Jen said, why canned instead of fresh artichokes? Time, I think, right?
What's that?
The artichoke hearts?
Yeah, just because you have to steam them for like an hour and then, you know, then you have to dig them out. They've done the work for you. It's just, you know, honestly, they've done the work for you. You don't really need to, honestly, you don't. So just let them do their thing. All we're going to do for that.
Brad wants to know if you've ever tried shaking your garlic in a mason jar to shell them.
I've seen that done before, but I just, you know what, the funny thing is, I just don't do it. There's really no reason I don't. It's just I'm so classically conditioned to do garlic this way.
Hey, Daniel Dennis joined.
Hey, what up, D?
And Boo.
Hey, Boo. Congratulations on your new dogs, Boo.
Sassafras.
Charlotte and Scarlet.
Scarlet and Charlotte. Sassafras and what?
I don't know, dude. I bet she's yelling like crazy right now, though.
Daniel Deans did the meatloaf last week.
Oh, did he really?
How'd it turn out, Dan? Y'all, Deans. Sorry, I didn't want him to think
Dan,
I was talking to
Dan. Y'all, Deans.
I didn't want him to think I was talking to Dan.
All right, so here we go. So we're gonna do our chicken to slide over a little bit.
Tony wants to know if you would choose cooking over radio if you could go back in time. Golf isn't an option, LOL.
I don't know. I enjoy my radio career. I honestly really enjoy it. That part of me has to kind of get out. I do love cooking, though. You know, I said I'd never open a restaurant. I honestly don't know if I could say that's the truth anymore. I mean, if I had the right guy and the right idea and somebody that understood, I, that I was just an enthusiast and would want to do something. I don't know, man. The more I'm around this world, the more I enjoy doing it, and the more I think about it. Like, when we do this show, when we get done tonight, I'll already be thinking about what we're doing next week, and that's all I'll think about. Because I want it to be good. I want you guys to enjoy it. And it's kind of cool learning stuff. I mean, I think, you know.
Anthony loves you.
Tell Anthony, thank you.
And if they miss the other episodes, where can they find them?
PTKradio.com has them all. It links right to our Monsters.fm webpage. It has Primetime Kitchen right there. Also our Facebook page, Primetime Kitchen. PTK Radio also has all of our merch as well. And all the recipes for all the episodes that we've made, they're up there as well. This one will be up there tomorrow morning. You'll be able to catch it up. So let's go ahead and saute this red onion.
Mike thought that you were going to deglaze the pan.
I didn't do it because it had too much of the brown butter in there. But thanks for catching that, Mike. I really appreciate it.
What brand of olive oil do you recommend?
Sam's. No, I'm joking. I honestly don't have... I'm not looking at olive. I probably should care more about the olive oil that I use. My God, it does smell good.
It does. It smells delicious. You know, we have somebody from Chicago, somebody from St. Louis, somebody from New York. There was somebody from Australia.
Yeah, we've got some, I don't know, we've had some interesting... And these come in quarters, and I just put the can in. Look, man, this is like a bouillabaisse. I mean, the cool thing about this, piccata really, I think, is lemon, capers, and parsley. That's like the piccata. But as long as you have that, you can add whatever you want. I love artichoke hearts in mine. I've been doing it for a while. We actually like a little tomato in ours.
Yeah.
Fresh
Atlanta,
parsley. Huh?
Wyoming, Fort Lauderdale.
Oh, awesome, yeah.
Sorry.
So what we want to do is, and I don't want to caramelize these. I just kind of want to keep them moving. And I've already done that a little bit because this pan is just so ridiculously hot.
Yep.
Okay, artichoke's in.
Okay. I'm going to come over here again. That smells so good. I could eat just that.
That's probably a little too much artichoke.
No, it's fine. Eh. I love a lot of artichoke.
I do too. We love it.
Yeah.
So we're just going to saute these and heat them through real quick. We really want those onions to be done more than anything. And you're going to see just how fast this will do hickey.
Daniel said, add a little Wyoming to my piccata.
I want to get another beer.
All right, another beer. Another beer is coming. What beer are you drinking? Miami Vice.
I know Dan Lee knows about this.
Yeah. Oh, New Smyrna Beach. We love New Smyrna.
Oh, my God.
We were down on Flagler a couple weeks ago. Oh, so much fun.
But that cantina, that Star Wars bar.
Traders. Is that what you're talking about? Traders.
Traders is great.
Yeah.
All right, so we have some red onion. We have some artichoke hearts.
Yep.
We have some capers.
Yep.
And I because I want to keep the juice of my capers, I just use the tongue of my fork like that.
Right. Yeah. About how many is that? Or how much is that?
Tablespoon.
Yeah.
Tablespoon or so.
Okay.
I mean, again, it's how many ever you like. If you like yours caper heavy, caper heavy. Now, the reason why I'm doing this, because this is important. Do not put your lemon or your herbs in until the end. Because when you cook lemon down too much, you will get a flavor in your sauce that you can't lose. Your acid like this should be added at the end, and your fresh herbs should go in at the end as well. You're going to get the absolute best flavor that way, okay?
Okay.
So what we want to do is get this pan nice and hot, keep these things cooking good and crazy.
Yeah.
Get a little color on them.
Yeah.
All right. And I actually just turned my pan. You can smell that already. It smells like your stereotypical piccata.
So good.
When capers hit artichoke hearts,
yep.
That flavor or that smell is you unmistakable. You can't. Can't, no chance. It's a wine.
What kind?
This is Sauvignon Blanc. You can use Pinot Gris. Any dry white wine will do. I would say don't do Riesling or Moscato or Chardonnay. Sauvignon Blanc is going to be your best. And really, Sauvignon Blanc is a cheap wine to begin with. You can get a bottle for $9 and it'll last you forever.
Okay.
We're going to do about half a cup, 3/4 of a cup of wine.
Okay.
Now, this would have been deglazing. What Brian was talking about earlier is important. I'm glad he brought it up.
Yeah.
So when you cook, if I were to saute these chicken breasts in this pan, I've got those great bits left over, that burnt skin, that you know, all that chicken fat in there. You want that in there. So when you deglaze, when you hit that hot pan with any liquid, but we're using wine, it actually boils it off the bottom. That's why you take you scrape the bottom, because you want all that off of there. We don't have to worry about that because, like I said, I had to wash it out because we had a little burnt butter in it. We don't want to do that. So while we're doing that, while that's kind of cooking down a little bit, we're going to add some chicken stock in a second before. But what I want to do is, these are plum tomatoes. Yeah. I like cooking with plum tomatoes. It's just, I can't explain it. It's just the tomato I like.
Yep.
It cuts easy, they have great flavor, and I like cooking with them. So I was just telling Tori, and again, if you get them at a place, you know, that, you know, unpaid for a plug here, but if we get them at Whole Foods, and you get, and I know tomato season's around, there's growers around here, you can find them from local farms as well. We get them from Whole Foods because we're, it's local, and it, or excuse me, it's easy to get to for us. We go up and we know we're gonna get good quality. But I will just sit here and cut these things and eat them with salt. These are going to go in dead last.
Daniel said plums are good for salsa as well. The
best.
They are.
That's what pico de mayo. Pico, right. That's what we use. I just made some mango habanero pico the other night to put on top of some chicken. I mean, I think we put a picture of it up on PrimeTime. It's very good.
We did.
Organic chicken stock.
Yeah.
After our wine is kind of reduced, hit it with some stock. That's probably about another half a cup. That's going to cook down.
Okay.
Okay, so we're going to cook this down. And you'll look our... Look how everything's ready to go. Do you see the chicken breast sweating?
Yeah.
The fat, that's when we know we're close.
Let me see if I can get closer.
See that?
Yeah.
That's good. Now, close that right up, because our sauce is almost done. I'm gonna turn this right up to 350. I'm gonna make sure we got a good finish temperature.
Daniel said that he needs to come over every Tuesday.
And this piccata, when that cooks down, if we don't have the slurry we want, if we don't have the consistency we want, I'll show you guys the oldest trick in the book where you can actually thicken up a sauce a little bit. And it's funny because I called myself out a couple times for doing this. But we're going to make what they call slurry. This is cornstarch.
Yeah.
We might not even need this, guys.
Okay.
But I'm going to show you anyway. We may do it just to show you the technique of thickening sauces using a slurry, okay?
Okay. Is that cheating?
It is cheating a little bit. Did somebody call me out on it?
No.
It was cheating a little bit.
It was me. I'm sorry.
Chicken stock and cornstarch.
Okay.
And the ratios really don't even matter. Okay? So you're stirring this up. And that right there, that what they call a slurry, has massive thickening abilities.
Okay?
So you'll see. Because we need a volume of sauce. And believe it or not, you know, there are people in restaurants called sauciers, and they come in and their entire job is all they do is make sauces all day because it takes forever to cook it down and really get that great flavor. Okay, so we have a good char here too. So
Ramon's a new follower.
Okay. So we have our white asparagus.
Yeah.
Right? Okay. And what we're going to do is we have olive oil, salt, and pepper, and that's it.
Yep.
We have our hot griddle pan.
Yeah.
And we're going to char braise this. So we're going to set this across the grill mark, and we'll get those killer grill marks. And at the very end, we're going to pour in about a tablespoon of chicken stock. It's going to hit that hot pan. It's going to steam braise it. So they're beautiful and delicious.
Paul said the lighting in here makes you look like the real Slim Shady.
I think that guy.
I love you, Paul.
She does not love you, Paul. Trust me, Paul, she does not love you. She can barely tolerate me. Man, this is going to be great. Okay, so let's go check the asparagus.
Jason said, don't mix in a ceramic bowl with the fork. It's the worst sound ever.
That's all I'm going to do now.
That's going to be our background music.
That's got to be an ass. I'm going to do it. Okay, so look.
Okay. Patrick said don't burn down the kitchen again. Wow.
So we're going to set those there.
Yeah.
All right. Now, this is ready to go. So let's go ahead and let's go bring this down, that temperature down a little bit.
Okay.
All right. We're going to add tomato.
I'm going to come back over here.
We're going to add...
We get tomato. Leon, it's not George Foreman. It's a cast iron.
Oh.
But we're not above George Foreman. We're not bougie here.
We're a little bougie. So we have some flat leaf parsley.
Okay.
Flat leaf parsley.
Okay. Where'd you learn to cook?
Just loving it and just learning how to cook through paying attention. And I don't really know how to tell you.
Where'd the love for cooking come from?
Really, I don't know, dude. I just like seeing people. I like to eat good food. So really, the love of it came from me wanting to eat good food. My grandmother was a big, huge inspiration in my life. I've talked about that on Primetime Kitchen often, and we find that a lot of our chefs that come in and visit were influenced by their grandmothers heavily, I might add. So we're gonna do a little story. Now look, see how thin that sauce is?
Yeah.
And we're gonna add a lot. Okay. We want that much because we're also gonna hit this with some butter.
Because butter equals
flavor.
Lots of flavor. Brian loves food.
Oh. Thanks, Brian. Brian's a sharer.
We're making chicken piccata with roasted red peppers, zucchini
cakes.
And some white asparagus. Look at that.
Little roll mark.
Daniel said, oh man, put that butter in.
Oh, I'm good. I'm putting that butter in, boy.
Ew.
Oh boy, I'm putting that butter in. Here we go, butter in. Look at it.
Let me see. How much? How much was that?
2 tablespoons.
That was a lot.
Lemon. Now, I did this because of this. Do not add butter to a hot pan. Turns off.
Yep.
Now see how our sauce is sticking me up?
Yes.
See how it's got that good color you want?
Yep.
Right?
Yep.
The good consistency we want?
Yep.
We can just let that sit. That is done. Oh, man.
Marissa likes your green skillet.
Oh, man.
Is that delicious?
It's good.
Can I taste it?
You cannot.
Daniel Dean said butter and blondes. I hope you're not talking about my daughter in the background, because I will kill you.
Oh, yeah. Everybody does.
Oh, hold on. That's really, really good. White versus green asparagus. Taste the same? Question mark?
I don't know. I've never had white asparagus.
Oh.
You know why I bought this? I bought this because our buddy Theo over at Willow Tree.
Yeah.
Said it was awesome. And said that Germany has like holidays built around this vegetable. That
really?
when this season comes in, people genuinely lose their S. And they have festivals and all kinds of crazy stuff, which I thought was kind of cool. Now, by turning this, I can feel it's not quite done. And that's where our char braising, which is a term I'm virtually certain I just made up.
You did. It's fine.
Hear that?
Own it. You should own that.
I'm going to own it.
That's your term.
I've owned it.
Char braising.
Own. Now, with these pans, you don't necessarily have to have a lid. You can do this on a grill. Whatever. Honestly, what I'm going to do, because I want this cooked through, because my wife doesn't like crunchy vegetables.
I know. I like crunchy vegetables. You're telling lies. You're sprinkling this whole all with lies.
That's understood. But listen, we are going to go ahead and do this vegetable. And it's going to be delish. Bears. We're almost done.
Hey, Andrea. Sean said, what kind of hot dogs were those?
Hot dogs.
I guess they look like hot dogs. Okay, I don't know. I've never seen a white hot dog before. What's happening here? Oh, you're steaming them. Oh, that's so smart.
With chicken stock.
Yeah, that's good.
So that's going to kind of flash braise. That's kind of what braising does. And what that's going to do, obviously, now look, dude, if you want to get real creative, you can do this with a lot of different liquids. It doesn't have to be chicken stock. I mean, if you want to try some other crazy stuff, you can. But
you use wine?
You could use wine.
Oh, okay.
I don't know if it's going to help any. I don't know if it's going to make it taste any better, but you can do that. Try this plate.
We're ready to plate?
Oh, we're pretty ready to plate.
Look at you. Hold on. Let me get over there. I'm not in the plating position.
All
right. Let me have some of this wine right here. Cheers. Cheers.
Guys, thanks for tuning in. I hope these shows aren't too long. We're actually trying to keep this one like 45 minutes or so. We're like at 51. I'm doing my best. I hope they're not too long. If they are, just give us some feedback. You know, we'll listen.
You're at 54.
Yeah.
More lies.
I'll listen, I promise. I'll do my best. But I want you guys to have a good meal, and sometimes it takes a little bit longer to make this for you guys as we're kind of talking about the techniques and stuff. And again, if you don't have, well, you'll be able to get the recipe tomorrow, ptkradio.com.
Yep.
And This is available?
No, not yet. It will not be yet.
Oh, and hit the flip so people can see your shirt.
Oh. So I just found this button. No, it's the same one you have on.
Yeah, so it's the same one.
Turn around. Yep. Turn around and show the back.
These are Fresh Cuts shirts.
Hold on, I'm trying to push the button. Okay. Yay!
They're available right now. So you can get that. We also have tumblers and glassware. And also, our next PTK Live is next Wednesday, the 14th at Marlowe's Lee Vista.
Oh my God, I can't wait. And there's so much fun.
Gotta book your tickets because, okay, check that menu out. Tell me what you think. I think it's one of the best menus we've had. And the portion sizes are gonna be great. You're gonna have plenty of beer. It's gonna be a reception beer. A chef surprise is coming. So we're really excited. And they're great fans of the show. And they really have been supportive of Primetime Kitchen since we started. They bought our very first PTK Live. And the guys Blake and the whole crew over there, we can't thank them enough. All their Alan, the management group, is a great bunch of guys. And Marlowe's Tavern, by the way, always good, consistent food. And their bar doesn't get enough recognition because it's amazingly good. Their appetizer menu is one of the best in the city. That, by the way, that was voted by not me. That's somebody else saying. Okay, let's build this dish, guys. So we have our cake, our zucchini roasted red pepper cakes. With
everybody's saying this is not too long, so good. You're good, babe.
Okay,
calm down.
So we have our roasted red pepper cake, our red roasted red pepper and zucchini cake.
Yep, that looks amazing.
Right in the middle of our plate.
Yes,
and that is a great crispy edge.
Mm-hmm.
Zucchini, parmesan, roasted red pepper, garlic, onion, paprika, everything you want in there. Now look, if you're a fan of like rosemary, throw some rosemary, thyme. Your favorite herbs go right in that. Really, they do. And they'll work just fine.
Lori, I've been to Marlowe's in Atlanta for volleyball tournaments. That looks delicious. Hey, Jeff. Jimmy wants you to taste the asparagus and let us know what you think.
Oh, yeah, cool. Hold on. I'll do that.
Okay.
Oh, that's so hot right now, though. Hiya! 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 It tastes like a white version of the green asparagus.
Does it taste like asparagus?
Yeah, it tastes just like green asparagus.
Oh, okay.
So this is going to be yours.
Okay.
Chicken breast right on top.
Mmm. What's that batter? What batter did we use?
It's just that breadcrumb. Not breadcrumb, it's flour.
Okay.
It's an egg wash with salt and pepper. Really nothing big. So because we want a good color on this plate, I'd actually like to kind of start on
spreading
the outside
it.
Of my plate a little bit.
Okay.
And look, this is not a science.
Well, that looks amazing.
Okay. And then, of course, we're going to finish this off with a little bit of fresh chopped parsley. And I'll tear this. I'm just going to tear it apart.
Tony wants to know if you can come over, cook for him, and leave before his wife gets home.
I cannot.
He wants to know how much. He'll pay. He's got money.
Okay. And although you don't need it, and although it doesn't really matter, a lot of times this little dish loves an extra little squirt of lemon to bring those capers and all that back to life. So I actually put a little bit of a lemon on top of mine. Excuse me, that's the wrong way to do it, Jimmy. You dope. There you go. Like that. And there you have it, guys. So what we have tonight is you have the zucchini cake at the bottom. It's got roasted red pepper, parmesan cheese, garlic, onion, paprika, and some zucchini. Absolutely delicious. Pretty healthy too, guys. Char-braised white asparagus. Which is just basically char crusted and then braised at the end with chicken stock, and a simple breast with some piccata sauce that has artichokes, it has capers, lemon, fresh parsley, tomato, and red onion. That is a really good dish, and you can make it easily at your house. We'll put the recipe up at ptkradio.com. That'll be up tomorrow. And I hope you guys had a good time for episode 5. I want to thank Whole Foods because they gave us some great food to work with tonight. Also, MIA Beers, the beer we're doing tonight. Also, Decoy. Decoy. What is Decoy?
Decoy.
Mm-hmm.
It's Decoy.
Decoy. Check out all of our social media outlets if you don't mind. Primetime Kitchen on Instagram and on Twitter. We'd love to get the Twitter numbers up. If you guys could help us there, that'd be awesome. That's PTK Real Radio on Twitter. And, of course, you know where the Facebook page is. You're on it now. It's Primetime Kitchen. PTKradio.com. Don't forget the live event next Wednesday. We hope to see you guys there. And after episode 5, I can't thank you guys enough for supporting Primetime Kitchen and PTK's How Tuesdays every Tuesday, 7 o'clock, right here. We'll see you guys next week.